Hello, everybody, and welcome back. It's round two of the Gauntlet stage, and we're going to go ahead and flip it over to the Yomi Conference with George Mason University, the second seed in the Gauntlet, taking on Penn State, who were the fourth seeds coming into this one. My name is J-Mac Tucker. Sticking around with me for the remainder of this is going to be Gorm Meiser.
Yeah, and it's looking like some great sets. I mean, we just got out of probably, I'm going to say, one of the best ones that we could have seen watching Calvin College and Bowling Green. Bowling Green being able to move forward. These two teams trying to essentially replicate that going forward, trying to find which one is going to go for. And honestly, I mean, I personally am always hoping for another three-game set, but I know both of these teams are hoping for the 2-0.
I mean, and this is a returning rival matchup. Last time these two teams met, it did go to a game three, and George Mason was able to get the advantage, taking that third game in their favor. Sylvanas is going to be the first god locked in on the side of George Mason, and Penn State's going to return with the Susanoo Zeus. And looking at the bans, Kabrakan, Terra on the side of George Mason, taking off one big guardian and another big healer. And over on the side of Penn State, they're getting rid of the Hoonbat Scotty, leaving this Thanatos open yet again. A lot more teams are open to keeping this big god open right now.
You know, Susanoo is one of the ones lately. I have seen him picked up a bunch, and yet each time I've seen him be very, very low impact. I feel like he hasn't made as big of a change in the game that he could have. Of course, that could be completely different here for Penn State, who's going to be looking for that. And plus, with that Zeus pickup as well, I'm honestly really interested because there's a lot of damage on the board for them. But there's that Thanatos you were just talking about, and that's going to be locked in for George Mason. And I believe, I mean, the last time we got to watch these teams kind of come through, like you said, it got pushed to a game three. They're both very, very close. Looking at this matchup, I mean, right now, it's exactly where you would want it. One team has the damage, but they don't have quite as much lockdown as you would want. On the other side, they have the healing and that early game Thanatos to kind of eat through. But Hercules going to be the next one who gets locked in, probably going in that solo lane.
I'm looking at an Odin right now. I mean, it's available. I don't see why Penn State wouldn't pick it up here. There's two big healers on their side and three members who can't get out of the cage, but instead, they're going to go ahead and lock in the Geb for the safety to help out that Susanoo and Zeus. George, Penn State opting for the first ban here to see what they're going to take off the board. But George State, they got to take this Odin off now. Now that it hasn't been picked up, it's got to be taken off the board.
That's definitely something they should look at. Thoth going to be removed from the game right here, and I'd like that ban out on the other side. We're going to be seeing there's the Odin list, like you had said. A very smart removal, really, just to get rid of that one. And Scylla, someone we saw perform exceedingly well on Coco Scones. Of course, we've learned now, if you focus her down, there's not much she can do, but not wanting to deal with that at all in the first place is going to be that. And now the last ban. Moving forward, it really could kind of be anything. We do still need a Hunter or a solo laner on the other side. And with Odin being removed, I wouldn't be surprised to see maybe one of the top pick Hunters come out. But really, all of them can kind of have the same impact right now. And it is actually going to be the Medusa removed, easily one of the top. The only other one I could have think of that may have been taken out there would have been the Rom.
Yeah, I think the Medusa is a smart one. She's very safe. She can go in really into either position if you want to run her as a Hunter or a mid lane. But since they do have that Zeus picked up, that will be the Hunter taken off the table for them. Option back over now to Penn State to see what they're going to pick up. And right now they're hovering over this Chalk, a god who has been kind of, I think in some eyes, been a little bit undervalued or underappreciated, but going to be locked in on the side of Penn State. That's going to be going over to their solo laner. And now the ball is in George Mason's court.
I'm still very excited to see. I mean, Chalk is someone that we haven't seen. There is going to be the Rom being hovered over right there. And I feel like we're going to be looking at that locked in. No problem right there. Immediately going to get grabbed up. And now looking for essentially what is ever left of this mid lane. We have Zeus off the board. Still a Thoth taken away. But that Yanis is open. And when you want to walk through walls, that is exactly who you should be looking at. And I expect to see that one locked in confirmed. Although they're going to be switching around. Actually, now just flipping over. Looking at the Nuwa as well, honestly, either of them could work. I feel like Yanis, a little bit more damage overall coming out of him and a little bit more utility, but Nuwa having that global presence and the stuns that she has is going to get locked in there. And there's a lot of potential setup here for them with the rest of their crew. They can kind of help out, get this Rama, allow him to snipe down, allow the Thanatos to do exactly what Thanatos wants to do and move forward. And now it's going to be up to this last one. Mineus is going to be picking for his team the ADC that they need.
Yeah, I do also like the Nuaw being picked up to try and get people just into that last tick of the Thanatos threshold. If they're just a little too high up in HP to be able to get into the execution, Nuaw is going to be able to globally provide that for the team, as well as act as more than anything a global ward to see any spot out any kind of big rotations or groupings on the side of Penn State. They're currently looking at the Uller to be their hunter pickup here. There's still quite a few other hunters to pick up, but instead they're going to go ahead and lock that one in for their team. We now have all 10 gods picked up here. Who are you giving this early game, or who are you giving this game to just off the draft alone?
I'll be honest, it's kind of back and forth when I'm looking at it. I mean, early game, Thanatos obviously should be the one who kind of excels there. And when you look at one side, you know, Uller is very player dependent. Uller is very much a, is this person going to be able to succeed or are they going to falter against the ROM when it comes down to it? That one's just going to have to be seen in the game. But when I'm looking at the Chalk and the Hercules, I feel like Hercules is going to be a little bit stronger overall. I feel Penn State being able to pull out of this, but George Mason has shown they're strong. Both of these teams have gone neck and neck and blow for blow every step of the way. So I kind of expect this one to be relatively similar to that last game we watched where we saw a just very dead even for several minutes. One misstep, one misplay from one of these teams results in the game.
Yeah, I mean, it's just also coming down to the comfort picks on all of these players. I know that Zidryu loves playing this Hercules. He played it yesterday against Tarrant County College. And while he didn't have the biggest success on it, was still trying to be that big, beefy frontliner for his team. So him getting kind of his go-to god more than anything else is going to be a big plus side for George Mason. And just my luck picking up one of the gods that we don't see too often, but is in their god pool, and they've played it to a fairly strong extent. Kind of was expecting more of the Isis pickup, but they're going more towards that late game global presence in the new Nuaw. So we'll see just how this first game goes against George Mason and Penn State University. You're not going to want to miss out because we've got another big potential best of three set coming from this one. Hello, everybody, and welcome back. Apologies for the delay, but we are into the game. Game one, George Mason University taking on Penn State in the rival grudge match. My name is Jim Mac Tucker. With me is Gore Miser.
And again, we're looking at essentially kind of a repeat of what we saw just a couple weeks ago with these two teams duking it out, trying to get this last hand spot right now. The thing that's kind of interesting, we've seen Chalk go for a little bit of proxy farm there in the back line. It's going to be a little bit spotted out, but not a big rotation coming over. And again, I think we saw Penn State do a start similar to this. We've seen Uller instead going for the red buff instead of just defending his own lane. And this is something I've seen actually Benny Hugh do a lot with Astral Authority in the Challengers area. This is something that I expect to see kind of be somewhat successful. It's when you have this late game character, you're going to be looking for those early game pushes. But that did allow, I mean, Havoc and Starkey just to kind of come forward. Now they're in a good position to steal away the jungler.
Yeah, I mean, they had the pressure in both the mid and the duo lane. So instead of going over to that speed buff because they lost pressure over there, they instead decided to invade onto this top side. They're going to get the red buff, try and secure themselves this purple buff as well, and make the rotation back into the mid lane. Penny's going to be able to make sure they get that mid lane pressure early on. That's it. He's going to apply a little bit of pressure and actually burn through that shield, but three charges on, but no detonate. Did not realize that he had the chain lightning instead of detonate. So going to be forced to use that Aegis very early on FDD, and now yeah, it's going to push them very deep under their tower.
And having that chain lightning, I mean, that was like the perfect scenario for the setup as well. Your minion's alive, you've just cleared out theirs. And they are standing just close enough that you can bounce those charges. And as we see, we're going to see them heal back up of that using those health potions and those mana potions. But overall, it is going to be a very big win for the Zeus, just showing kind of the prowess. This is the reason that we see Zeus get banned out some of these times, is because of his ability to just deal the damage.
Yeah, but I mean, now that George Mason needs to be really careful, as Penny is level 3, does have access to that detonate if they so wish to go for it. And one more disaster like that, now with the Aegis off the line for FDD, that could potentially spell their death, but instead they're going to go ahead and farm up those mid camps, and the dual lane going to come over to these Oracle Harpies, pick those ones up for their team, get a little bit of extra gold and experience for their team, putting them up to level 4 over in that dual lane, getting a little bit of a lead.
So the thing I'm looking at this game, and we kind of talked about it while you were asking me, I mean, you asked which team would I really give this to. I'm looking towards this Chalk just to see him, what kind of impact he is going to have, because He has big AoE knockup silence, which can be very, very impactful in the middle of a team fight. I think we actually got to see one game very recently that turned everything around. Just one shock, as I think I told it was my play of the game. Azidru now having a taste what that shock can do and is going to be able to push that forward. And I actually believe that it was with Penn State that we're able to kind of turn that one around. So Chalk being something that they're pulling back into this, I expect to see it be high impact. Getting that first blood is going to be very good for them. Chain Lightning doing a little bit more damage there. Detonate not quite filling what you would want out of the burst, but with Manias in the neighborhood, everyone just going to back away on George Mace.
Yeah, just going to go ahead, back up, farm up what they need to do, as they're a little bit at a disadvantage as far as the level 5 game goes. One level 5 apiece and a level 6 on this Chalk, getting the mad pressure over in that solo lane onto Zidru. He's sitting almost at half HP yet again, and he just got back to lane. Teleport will be down for him if he gets too low again. Still has not proc'd into that level 5 either. Does not have access to the CC immunity of the boulder that everybody loves on that Hercules. And now, Elemental Camp's going to be three-way split amongst the mid jungle and the support. Support kind of being that roaming second jungler. Now, FTD maybe looking for a potential gank over here on to Wiggles, as he is pushed up. Level 5 is available for Zidru, and that's 3 members. The boulder has already been used. Wiggles going to be able to get that big AoE silence off. Knock up 2 with the storm call as well. The typhoon going to be good. Wiggles, however, in a dangerous spot, sitting at low HP, is going to be executed out, but it's going to trade out. Zidru going to get the return kill, and actually Manais going to pull it back and get 2 for his team.
Honestly, a potential 3 kills there right there. Not able to fully grab that last one for Penn State, but being able to turn that around 2-for-1 right now. George Mason not feeling very happy about that rotation going through Manas. Truly proving what he can do. And I was saying, I've seen a lot of Susanna's low impact. Right now, trying to prove that wrong immediately. 3 kills and 0 deaths right now. The only one being attributed to that shock in that last engagement, really. Being able to kind of control this right now, the jungler looking very strong, potentially able to find something else. And now a 3 rotation Zidru one more time, getting caught out, a lot of damage coming through, and it's going to be another pullback. Manias picking up the 4th kill for his team.
Use that driving strike to try and shove back Manais, but unfortunately did not recognize there were 3 other people in that area and was able to get the 3rd death now onto this Hercules. Zidru not having the best performance this weekend, as yesterday he was also somewhat underperforming against Tarrant County, and I think some of that is still looming with him, as he's really not able to do anything right now. Mid lane, Just My Luck is able to get a little bit of a farm advantage over Penny. Going into the later stages, that's going to be very impactful to get that Nuwa online as quick as possible. But mid camp's going to be dropped over on the side. I believe Penn State got both of those ones there. That's a little difficult to tell from the distance I was. Oracle Harpies, however, are going to be going their way.
And right now, this is another strength of Zeus right there, using that Chain Lightning. While it might pull the Gold Fury just off by the off chance of kind of leaking over there, he has great clear for the mid camps and for those Oracle Harpies, using that Chain Lightning. Just kind of bounce back and forth and get that damage down. As now, FDD going to get aggressive on the Totem Pole, but missing that Death Scythe might turn this around. The stun not going to be coming through from the Uller, but a lot of damage getting thrown out there. And he's going to be ultimately falling back, allowing the ADC to come through and clear some of that experience up, pick up some of that gold, and ultimately back away. And that is, again, that was just kind of a gank that just did not go their way. It didn't particularly go for Penn State that time around, but at least they were not able to lose a kill for Penn State. They're feeling very good about the lead.
I think Penn State is really focusing on what they needed to, which was focusing down Zidru on this Hercules, putting up the pressure out in the solo lane, making sure that he could not be the high-impact player that George Mason needs. And I think they're doing a fantastic job at this game, as they have already put 3 deaths on the side of this Hercules, and he's been denied his blue buff every single time. Now forced to back and use that teleport one more time, sitting 2 levels down at the moment. If we look at the graphs, it's very reflective in that 2200 experience and 2000 gold, trying to get another return kill onto this one. Possibly Zidru gonna use that driving strike on the wave, however, and so that's gonna spell the disengage for Wiggles. Spots out that Thanatos rotation, gonna back off no problem.
And right now, that level advantage is not only in the solo lane, but in the jungle as well. Of course, Susanoo with 4 kills on his belt is going to be able to have the lead. Right now, he's looking to try and get Starkey down one more time, trying to find the 5th kill for his team. Penny going to be able to pick up that one. Just My Luck going to get caught out, going up into the air right now. Not going to get knocked out by that. Although the Russo going to come crashing down. FTD going to be able to turn that one into a kill for him, but he's stuck between 4. 3 charges on his belt. Penny waiting patiently, going to be using that detonate, I'm sure. And Wiggles DeBay going to be able to pick that one up right there. And while we do get to see Just My Luck make make it out of there alive. That sets them up to go ahead, Penn State, turn around and pick up that Gold Fury. But Rom is in the neighborhood. He does not have his snipes, though, so he's going to have to hope for either an Astral Arrow that's really lucky or maybe a setup to try and turn this fight around.
Yeah, just my luck trying to get something from the side. Throws out the fog, but they pull it away from the Gold Fury. CM Havoc's able to pick up one, but he's probably going to trade out his life here. The minions are good. The Clay stun as well, but it's not going to be enough damage to take down Lurmy. Penny's going to be able to pick up CM Havoc and pulls George Mason into the 7-3 lead right now at only the 8-minute mark.
Now, that's one of those scenarios that had we seen Havoc have those snipes available, that's something that I've seen a ton lately where we have been watching. A ROM snipe is perfect for stealing away that Gold Fury. You can stay safe. You don't have to run into the enemy, much like we just saw there. But it also is doing enough damage that if he's going to throw down one, two shots, he can confirm that before anyone's able to burst it down from Penn State. But Penn State able to completely confirm that one now. And without really burning a lot, I mean, beads are going to be down for Penny, and we're going to be seeing Chalk's teleport down as he returns to his lane. But overall, I mean, everything is just looking good. In fact, Wiggles actually showing, I guess, kind of how good he feels about this right now. Going to be forced to use his ultimate entity going up in the air. But really, no true worries coming out from the Chalk.
I mean, this is just what Wiggles has been doing all game, is applying that pressure in the jungle side, not allowing Zidri to get a hold of that blue buff, denying as much experience, gold, and more importantly, mana on the side of Hercules. The man of a million mana points doesn't have access to that mana point when his blue buff is gone. Zidrio not having the same impact as he normally would have, and that's really thanks to Wiggles and Manice from getting that early first three kills actually onto this Hercules.
And right now we're sitting at 9 minutes in. It's looking like FDD still trying to do something. Gonna be able to connect a death slide. The pull gonna be good from Star. He actually, Laramie Wormy gonna be in a little bit of trouble with the knockup gonna be coming. He's not gonna connect from anybody. Manae's gonna get knocked up here. The stun gonna be coming out. Laramie Wormy again in trouble. Meditation gonna be coming out. The shield's gonna be good, but that's not gonna save his entire life. The stun coming down, and she is going to be able to turn that around with the help of Penny coming in there, one hit away, and it's gonna be picked up. Just my luck. We'll find the kill on the Laramie Wormy. But that was exactly the rotation that they needed out of Penny for Penn State.
I mean, they just stopped him in place. Lurmy Wormy able to get that Cataclysm and the knockup from Wiggles inside of that Zeus ultimate. Penny able to pick up the double kill with that one and push their lead that much further. 4,000 gold thanks to that tier 1 tower dropping and 4,400 experience. Penn State are not happy about their loss during the season, and they're coming back with a vengeance in these championships.
And now they're going to be turning that one immediately over to this Portal Demon. Going to be started up, and Manae has taken that one, but ultimately they do have the ability to swap this around. Looking at Zidru coming in, does not have the boulder available, but waiting patiently in the waves. Going to get the knockup. Going to try to go forward with the Driving Strike, not going to be able to get anything now. Trying to run away, Wiggles going to be chasing him down. Starkey going to come up to heal them around. And Laramie Wormy ultimately going to just use that shield back away. The team got what they wanted. They got what they came for. But Thanatos is not done with you yet. Penny in the backline getting very low. Going to get pulled right back into it. Zidru going to be able to get that one with the push through. And now he's getting pulled back to his doom. But the meditation one more time going to be able to save George Mason there. And while there's a little bit of poke coming out from Wiggles, they can walk away knowing they shut down that Zeus.
Yeah, I mean, that's the important part, is shutting down that 4-1 Zeus. Just been providing so much damage and utility for his team, making sure that they can keep up that pressure in the mid lane. Because a Zeus in the late game, if he's not shut down, is infinitely going to be more useful than a new walk. Now they're looking to pressure out this solo lane as Totable has made the full rotation over to the solo lane, and Zidru has nowhere to go. Going to be taken down. That's going to be the first kill over in this engagement. Three members hit by the axe. Wheel's going to get stunned out there, and we just saw the Hunter rotate over to the solo lane at 11 minutes in the game.
It was 11 minutes in the game, not only having that rotation, but right now FDD barely getting away from that, using that Aegis just in case to be able to walk away there. Very, very, very low health right now. It's going to be looking like a one-for-one trade in towers, depending on how Havoc can do over here in the duo lane. But now, eyeing that, seeing the map, knowing what they can do, we are going to see Penn State immediately go for this tier 2. Zidru going to be teleporting in. The ult's channeled waiting for him, and he is erased the minute he shows up. Welcome back to lane, my friend. Go ahead and sit down.
It's just been the name of the game. Shut down Zidru. He has not been able to do anything for his team. And if you look at the net worth, he's sitting third amongst his team. But barely. I mean, it's fluctuating between him, the mid laner, and only a 300 gold difference between him and his support as well. And you look over in the left-hand side, Wiggles has made the full rotation to the dual lane to try and box out CM Hag. CM's getting the better end because he does have those dev gauntlets. He's turning the fight around in his favor. Axe is going to come down. He's going to be forced to roll away. Wiggles going to continue the aggression because Total Bull has now made the rotation in as well. But Wiggles too low to continue diving down to that tier 1 tower.
And now 10 seconds until this Gold Fairy respawns. Penn State looking to be in control of the game. I mean, 12 and a half minutes in, just a little bit ago, they only had a small lead. Now they've extended that further, especially with that tier 2 pickup on the right-hand side. 6,400 gold, 6,500 experience, and they are going to be able to kind of try and extend that a little bit as the Gold Fairy is available for them. Oracle Harpy is going to be split, so they do not get that free vision, but the wards in their inventory is definitely going to allow them to set up and maybe defend this or aggress on it and bait out another fight from George Mason.
Yeah, as you can see, they've made the rotation to ping over for this Gold Fury. They're going to go ahead and clear out two of the wards that were sitting onto that one. So now they know the pressure is on for this Gold Fury. Portal Demon is down at the moment. The portal no longer available to these teams. Sentry Ward going to be dropped for CM Havoc to make sure that he can take out that Penn State one. Teleport, however, is going to be good. It's going to force Havoc to go up into the sky. Force out the snipes early. The ultimate's not going to connect. He's just a little too far out of range. New Wall going to be good to try and spot out the rotation. Starkey going to knock up two with the Wrath of Terror, but that's just more than anything going to disengage the team fight. Minai's trying to push forward to get some extra damage out, and now Zidri has made the rotation over.
And now again, kind of coming to the stalemate, Zidri trying to find whatever he can do. Wiggles in the middle of it all, but not giving too much of a care, really. I mean, 14 on Shock, Pinky as he is, going to be using this ultimate, getting that silence. Penn State going to be able to get the Gold Fury, no problem. Right now, Thanatos up in the air, looking for something to get aggressive. But now Penn State is here, and they are ready to turn this one around. The stun going to be coming through. Starkey going to be the first one to come down, and Totable going to get credit for that kill. Falling back is the rest of the team, but unfortunately for you, Zidri, Hercules is not going to be able to run away too easily right now. Going to use his healing, trying to get away. Oh, that nice stun at the range from Notable Wiggles. Going to be able to pick that up.
That axe was beautiful, and that's what you want on your Uller players, is to hit those long range axe stuns, to not usually to set up for further kills, but instead able to pick up the kill with that one. Speaking of kill, there goes the tier 1 tower in the dual lane. That's going to be the second victim of that fight, and now they're pushing their way up into this tier 2 tower. Nothing for them to really defend onto this one. FDD, no ultimate from anybody on the side of George Mason. Only Zidri who has it, but he is still dead. Six of them on the side of this Hercules, and Penn State has done a phenomenal job shutting down this Hercules.
And right now, keeping control over all of the map and the game. One tier 2 still stands for George Mason in the mid lane. And 5 of the 6 original towers for Penn State are still standing. The only one they lost was earlier to Havoc, split pushing that left-hand tower there. But when we look at it, Portal Demon about to respawn, and then we look at the Fire Giant, which is probably a very tasty target for Penn State with the lead they have so far. I mean, after that engagement, Gold Fury, some kills, and another tier 2. They are now sitting up 10,500 gold, 10,000 experience on top of George Mason, and all of that is clean experience. No level 20s on the board for any team. And Portal Demon, that's just going to be another docket for Penn State. They just achieved that one, no problem. And George Mason are just having to fall back and see what they can defend.
I mean, that Portal Demon at this point is just the cherry on top of their ice cream sundae right now. Manae's going to be able to pull in CM Havoc, who is taking too much damage, forced up into the sky. Aegis has been popped early by Manae to make sure he can't take the damage from the snipe. Typhoon's going to be dropped down. He's going to knock up two. CM Havoc going to be the first one to fall, as Total is going to pick up that one. FDD up in the sky as well as their mid laner, but it's not going to be enough. Actually, FDD going to come crashing down into the middle of Total. Going to try and turn his aggression onto it. Going to be pulled in thanks to that Susanna. Going to get a good death side, but it's not going to be enough. Total picking up the unofficial triple kill for his team. And now the tier 2 tower is going to be the next one to fall.
And that is going to be the last tower online, the last one offline, I guess, really, for George Mason. Going to get knocked down there. Now it's going to be looking like it forward. The Phoenix going to be falling in no time right there. Mid will bird off the map. And now we see Penn State falling back. And at this point, that Fire Giant is open for them. They can try to bait a fight. They can continue their aggression. Laramie Wormy going to back heal, spend some of that gold they just earned, and ultimately be able to come back. The team right now in a great position. And compared to the last time we saw these two teams fight, Penn State has been doing some work and practicing.
Yeah, especially, I've been harping on it all game. Zidry is not able to do anything. They don't have that frontline pressure. They don't have the big, beefy Hercules that they normally do. They've been doing a fantastic job on this chalk. What you were saying, we need to see the big impact, and now the team fight has come through. Just by luck, going to be able to pick up Penny, be able to take the big damage off to start off, and F. Diddy going to be able to pick up Menace as well. That's going to be two members offline for Penn State. And Chalk's ultimate is still down. They used it early on into the engagement. Lurmy Wormy now caught in between the wall and three other members. Totable trying to do what they can on the side. Lurmy Wormy now forced to run away, but FTD's going to be able to get it with the execute. And now the fight is turning in favor of George Mason. FTD still onto the chase. Totable trying to run away. A great A is going to stop the death side. The third snipe and not going to connect. The second one was able to. Going to be pulled back. And now four-man wipe in favor of George Mason.
Only one left right here trying to get away. Gonna get stunned against the wall, but he does still have a 3-level advantage over Zidry. Not too worried about that. FDD now getting relatively low. The ult gonna be coming down, taking that damage, and that is gonna be a return kill. Starkey, the next one gonna be on the target, but the meditation coming out. Wiggles going to be turning that one around, trying to get out of here, but ultimately now taking a lot of damage. The knockup's gonna be good. That is going to be an ultimate deicide, kind of postponed very long by Wiggles there, but Havoc being able to get that and essentially bringing George Mason back into this game. That being said, only for the time being, the gold lead is still heavily in favor of Penn State, sitting at 11,500 and 7,000 on the other side for their experience, really just kind of sitting ahead. But this is where we can see George Mason trying to put themselves back on the board. Gold Fury will be spawning back in about 15 seconds, but Penn State has had a little bit of time to recuperate, and they are probably a little salty after that last fight.
Yeah, I mean, they lost Penny so early on into that fight, as well as Menace. They still, I believe they still had their ultimates online for it as well, so they didn't have access to that big damage in the Zeus and Susanoo. And that was what spelled disaster for that team fight, is because they picked them off so quick and so early. And we didn't have any follow-up damage and could not stop the aggression of George Mason. And that's what they need to continue looking at doing in these fights, is pick off this Zeus, pick off this Susanoo as early as possible. Penny's beads are still down for another 40 seconds. I expect this is when George Mason may want to look to get a big potential pick.
And right now it's going to be, big is the name of the game for them. Taking down Penny is what kind of led them to success there, as well as taking out Manias early on and not letting the rest of the team have that damage. But Penny being, a little bit more self-conscious here, they're going to go ahead and start up the Fire Giant one more time. But we do have, I want to point out, Havoc with his ultimate. I want to see him try and get the snipes down, go up in the air where you can hit this and try to steal it away for your team, as the rest of the team is maybe trying to pull them away, but they're not quite able to get in there. Fire Giant sitting a little bit below half health just now, and it's really going to be up to George Mason trying to go in. Starkey going to get caught out in the middle of it. All the stun going to be coming down. Notable going to be the first one taken off the board. Zidry going to be able to get credit for that. The snipe's going to be coming down. One going to connect, two going to connect, and now he's looking for the last shot and not able to quite get it right now. Trying to fight forward, though, is into Manias, trying to get it, but the knockup going to be good from Laramie Wormy. Penny going to be able to make it out of here alive, and it's going to be a 1-for-2 trade so far, as now we see Kev and Wiggles both trying to chase down FDD, who might be able to get away now with that little knockup going forward and his speed boost. So overall, three members still living for George Mason, but it opens up Penn State with four of them still alive, able to go back and be the Portal Demon or the Fire Giant.
I think that they're going to go for the Portal Demon onto this one. They don't really have any big secure ultimates right now to go onto this Fire Giant. They're just waiting for it to spawn. But, I've been wrong about a lot of things before, as Penn State is looking to start up this Fire Giant right now. Now turning their eyes over to the Portal Demon, they're going to go and leash that one away. Thanks for not turning me into a liar here. But three members of George Mason have met the aggression. Wiggles going to go up into that ultimate, knock up all three sides of Mount FDD, going to be the first one to pay with his life. And Zidry now forced to try and run away from the remainder. Starkey trying to get into this fight, trying to see what they can do, see if they can get a big ultimate, but they don't have it online right now. This is the unfortunate part. It's only Zidry who's got that ultimate online for this big team fight. Now they're going to chase down Starkey, make sure that he can go. Storm call is not, or the Typhoon is not going to be enough to pick that one up. And now they are on full retreat. Three members sitting under half HP.
All right, now trying to get away. Zidry not going to be able to get out of there alive. And now that's going to be three members still alive trying to defend Havoc, sitting back at his Phoenix. Of course, the mid Phoenix now respawned for George Mason here, and they've been able to kind of outlive that. But Penn State not looking to let that one live too long from here. Fire Giant can be started up, burst down as fast as they can. Geb shielding herself there. Laramie Wormy just trying to stay alive as the Fire Giant gonna get bursted away. Portal Demon should be the next on the target of the team. Then back, spend some gold, teleport right back into the middle of the map, and turn their sights back onto that half health middle Phoenix.
Yeah, I mean, that, I expect that's going to be their next target, is the weakened bird in the mid lane. They do still have option to go either towards that right or left side bird, but depending on how many they pick in the process, they could just look to end the game instead, as they do have quite a bit of damage on their side. Three members walking through the portal. Totable instead electing to walk back so he can go towards his buffs over on the left-hand side. Red and purple available. Speed buff up for Mane, so they're going to be able to pick that one up. Now, going to elect to ignore the blue buff here. Now, Zidru going to try and drop the speed buff for his team, but he needs to be careful because Mane is lurking around the corner, is going to get spotted, but they're going to ignore him for now and opt to go towards this mid lane bird.
And this is going to be the name of the team. Objectives are the focus. Starkey going to be taking a lot of damage. Just my luck getting burst around. Wiggles trying to go into the back line to get that, but the knockup going to be good from Zidru to pull him back. The bird is gone. Phoenix taken off the map. Middle lane going to be spawning those fire minions one more time. And Penn State going to be turning their sights over to this left-hand Phoenix. Now trying to take down the long lane bird. No problem for them as they go through again. Five members strong with fire time. The knockup from the Storm Season coming through. Going to be able to pick up one kill. The Storm's coming down from Zeus as well. Double kill for Mineas. And Penny going to be able to pick up Zidru. Now the Titan's exposed. The minions are here. And this is going to be Penn State looking to close out the game.
Yeah, it's going to be the first game of this best of three going in favor of Penn State with a commanding victory over George Mason. Just unable to do anything against this team. And Penn State showing that they want to move on to the last stage of this gauntlet.
And being able to kind of control that again. The last time we saw this, they were almost dead even in the teams. But we get to see George Mason. I mean, they still have one game to bring it back. And what's exactly what Calvin College had earlier on. They were able to kind of push that forward. When I look at it, I'm honestly looking. I mean, that Zeus was a huge issue. We're going to be looking at the Susanoo, who was a big issue. And Totable late game came online, but really those two were the big impact. Wiggles did a lot, but I feel like with the help of Manias early on, shutting down Zidru as much as they could is really what kind of pushed them forward. It's going to be interesting to see what Penn State is able to pull out next game. Is George Mason probably going to change around their picks and bans?
Yeah, I think that just my luck on this Nuwa did not provide enough for their team. They were able to get about 13, 14,000 player damage, but you got to remember this is a Nuwa. All they got to do is press 4, and they get quite a bit of that given to them for the most part. At 2, 0, and 5, it's not like just my luck was underperforming or anything. They just weren't providing enough for their team. They weren't getting that big peel that we've seen from just my luck's Isis, which I thought would have been a much better pick for them in this instance. And Zidru, as we mentioned, just not able to do anything. 3-9-5 on this Hercules. Just really their target of aggression. And we'll see what Penn State elects to go through with this next game and what George Mason will flip around in their picks and bans. Don't leave that computer, I guess. Not really a TV. You may be watching on TV, but don't leave. We'll be back with game two of George Mason versus Penn State to see who's going to move on or if we'll go into a game three.